Tyrone!
What?
What's up, bud? I like your shirt.
Thank you.
Got the truck all loaded up. Look at this. Look at her. That is one loaded up truck. The 740. The 3600 PSI. DeWalt, as we say here in the South. Wasted on you. All right. She's warm. Let's hit this open road. Oh, yeah.
So, I was a little worried about trying to take this truck all the way to New England from Tennessee. But this last time I pulled over, I was going to get some gas, and I had the windows down, and once I, you know, started like turning off the exit off the highway into the gas station, I heard this rattling, and I'm like, oh man, that doesn't sound good. And there's a whole bunch of rednecks right there in the gas station. I think I'm probably somewhere around Virginia. I don't think I'm that far, but I did go through the Smoky Mountains like a few hours back. I really don't know exactly where I am. I just stopped at this Comfort Inn. The rednecks, they love my truck. And yeah, we got along great. They were this close. They were calling guys to come over and try to help me like right now. And one guy was ready to do it. He just didn't have tools. And I didn't bring too many tools either. But there's a shop right across the street. It's gonna be back on the road.
Now that, ladies and gentlemen, what a knocking rod sounds like in your motor. How we doing, Brandon?
She's running. It's a good sign.
About to be right back on the road. Heading out of Marion, Virginia, up to Quincy, Massachusetts. Nice little stop here. Nice little stop in Marion. Excited to be back on the road. Well, yeah. On the job here in Marshfield, Massachusetts. Putting a couple coats of woodscapes on all this siding. And the faults. There's Jimmy. There's Timmy Two Coats. Tim Hall Painting. Getting her done.
Thank you.
Now this is the South Shore of Massachusetts. And if you make a trip to Massachusetts and don't see Nantasket Beach, did you really see Massachusetts?
Okay. So, I'm in the drive-thru of Dunkin' Donuts. My truck just broke down. Right at the window. Won't go into gear. All in a day's work. Load it up. Let's go paint a church in New Hampshire. New Hampshire. Made it all the way from Tennessee. Just sitting here in a little traffic. Boy, it sure is pretty out here, though. Tell you what. Hello. All right, guys, we made it. We are here in Tamworth, New Hampshire. And as you can see, we have arrived at our destination. It's been a long time coming. Finally here. Old Bertrude made it with all the ladders loaned from my buddies. Yep, new motor, a few other new parts. And we are ready to pound this thing out. What's up, guys? The funny thing is that this tool right here, not even available in the South. I've never seen one in Tennessee, and this is really what you need when scraping lead paint. This thing used to be called a Sandvic, or there was a company named Sandvic that made these scrapers, and it's got a carbide blade right there and a nice knob right here. Now you press down on the knob and you scrape only in one direction. If you go backwards and forth like this, like a lot of people want to do, you're only going to dull that carbide blade. So only in one direction like this and scrape all the lead. What a great job we have out here today, isn't it, guys? It's out here scraping lead with the carbide blade, getting that dust up in the air. Wait till I bust up my orbital sander and get a nice fine coating of lead all over my lungs. I love it. I love being a painter. I've got this whole place all prepped. Yesterday I came out and hit everything with the Mad Dog primer. And you can see it, some of the spots just, you know, still look very bare and stuff, but this is a primer that blocks tannins from bleeding through. You see that it is on there. It goes on like aqua fresh toothpaste and turns just a light bluish green, whitish clear. And all this stuff has been hit with it. I even did these railings and everything. And so you see, like, in some spots it does change color. And I went over this stuff a couple of times with it.
And from what I'm told, you don't really see that much of a difference until you paint it. That's when the paint will, you know, especially a high build paint, will just kind of sit on it and cover over everything and hides a lot of the alligator look that the lead paint leaves behind, the spider cracks and all that type of stuff. So, yep, we got it all ready to go. I'm gonna mask these windows and spray this bad boy out.
Alright, so we've made some progress. What I did was I pressure washed the whole front of this building, then I lightly sanded it. Didn't want to do too much sanding right after pressure washing and scraping. A lot of scraping. It was probably 2 full days of scraping after the pressure wash and just light kind of sanding stuff down. Not too much because it's all lead paint that you're dealing with. So after that, I hit it with a pretty much full coat of Mad Dog primer, if not 2 coats. You know, because it's one of the first time, I think it's the first time I ever used this stuff. Then I sprayed the whole thing out with the More Glow low luster. And after that, I sanded it all again and went through and caulked everything. And, you know, after that first coat of paint, it kind of lets you see what you're dealing with. And I went through and caulked everything, sanded it all down, got all the little hairs off the wood, you know, got it all nice and smooth, and then second coated it with the More Glow low luster. So we're in business now, baby, on all this low stuff. Full coat of primer, if not 2, and then 2 full finish coats on all this siding from the band down is now done. And now I'm getting started on all that high stuff, that top, which is in much better shape actually than all this low stuff was. So this was a ton of prep work. Right now I'm gonna do these doors actually. Then I'm gonna get up and tackle all of that.
Everyone seemed to think that you needed to rent a lift in order to do this job. As you can see, I got it with the 40. Saving people thousands everywhere I go.
Is he sleeping?
No.
These are my helpers for the day. The 3 of them. They did good. And we got her all finished up. How's it look, Owen?
Good.
I think so. You think we did a good job? I think we did. Look at them doors. Oh, yeah. It's a Hunter Green. Benjamin Moore Hunter Green Soft Gloss. Low luster. Standard white on the siding. Pressure wash this deck a number of times, got it nice and clean. There. Another one down. We're off to eat Chinese food. Beautiful Tamworth, New Hampshire.
Then put like half of it in the sink and then eat the other half.
You actually just eat entire sugar packets.
Oh no, not anymore.
Not anymore.
Delicious.
This kid's the sugar. Oh my goodness, sugar packet eating.
Don't do
king.
Sweeteners. The sweeteners aren't that good.
Oh my goodness, he's eating straight sweetener. Oh. Mm. Good. Mm-mm. Well.
that's a wrap, folks. It's kind of a gloomy and dreary day here in Quincy, Massachusetts. Finished up some painting at my brother's in New Hampshire late last night. Got back here about 11. Got that ride out of the way. I didn't want to start my journey back to Tennessee all the way up in New Hampshire. So I drove down to Massachusetts, stayed with Grammy one last night. It's been one heck of a trip, folks. About to bring old Bertrude here back down below the Mason-Dixon. Hope she makes it. You want to buy this bad boy, hit me up in the comments below. I will sell it for a reasonable offer. She is a beast. I do love her. But you know, sometimes it's nice to have something new. See ya! Pulled over into a Buc-ee's to get gas in the Smoky Mountains. Sevierville, Tennessee. If you're from the north, you don't know nothing about Buc-ee's.
Honey. All right.